Welcome to the 89th graduation ceremony of Lakeview High School. It's an honor to be principal of Lakeview High School. Over the past 13 years as an administrator at Lakeview High School, it has been my privilege to be a part of the education of the students at Lakeview High. I'm very proud of their accomplishments of this group of leaders, artists, athletes, and scholars. Congratulations. Your academic drive has paid off. All of the staff at Lakeview Public Schools have worked very hard to prepare each and every one of our students for the next phase of their journey in life, regardless of their chosen path. The administration and staff of Lakeview Public Schools wish them all great success in their lives and careers. I would now like to introduce Superintendent of Lakeview Public Schools, Carl Paulson.
Thank you, Mr. Kapla. Good evening to all, and thank you for clicking in and watching this important event. Our Board of Education, administration, staff, and special guests are pleased that you've joined us. Seniors, you made it. And tonight, we are proud of you. Parents, you made it. And tonight, we are pleased for you. Faculty, you made it happen. And today, I am relieved for you. Every year when I start thinking about what I might want to say to the graduating class, it becomes an anxious moment. I'm pretty experienced at this process, having been a school administrator for 25 years. At Lakeview, I've had the honor of making graduation speeches for the past 12 years, and I take each time to make sure my comments are unique and appropriate to the circumstances and to the class. For many of you, I have been your only superintendent while you've been in Lakeview. There is little doubt this year's class demonstrated more resolve, commitment, and focus than any class in my experience. And noting my gray hair, I say this from experience. Even a hardliner like me got broken down the past few years because of your tenacious emails and Twitter comments hoping for snow days. I've got to admit, you found some creative ways to encourage me with those pictures on Twitter and Snapchat. So I admit it, I broke down. I think during your 4 years of high school, you may have had the most snow days called of any recent graduating class. So I apologize for cheating you out of all of that educational time. Also, just think of some of the important things you've had to live through growing up. You saw the disappearance of the hardline phone in your home, where in the old days, every conversation was a family affair. And of course, all of you have to endure now carrying a cell phone in your hand or your pocket or your purse all the time. You were some of the first middle school students who had to hear us talk about the concept of cyberbullying. And to make matters worse, you've now lived through the change from Snapchat to TikTok. Even worse, you now have to watch TV, if that's what we even call it anymore, and binge without commercials a whole season of shows through Netflix or Hulu. As if that wasn't enough. Besides all of the passwords you have to remember, you even expanded the world's vocabulary with things on text like OMG, LOL, IDK, SMH, or the ever popular LMAO. Can I even say LMAO on video? So much you have overcome. This year's class has beaten records for final completion. A higher percentage of seniors actually earned their diploma on time this year than any group in the past. For that, I applaud you and say, great job. Even more important, this year's class has found it in their heart to volunteer a huge amount. This, too, is making a positive impact on our community, and it's worthy of recognition. Further, even though spring sports were canceled, our seniors have had one of the most successful careers in Lakeview athletics history. All of those championships and playoff appearances, amazing. Still others have shown success and performed in great shows and plays and band and orchestra, or worked with clubs and other extracurriculars. For me, I think about what this class has needed to overcome and know that what you lost because of the virus will not hold you back. Your success prior to the virus demonstrates what you are capable of in the future. I am sad and disappointed with you for losing all of the typical senior events, but I am excited for you because of what I know you can do in the future. So today is a celebration. The accomplishments I mentioned are a reflection of what you have done. You lived the year until today as seniors. The challenges you will face looking forward are what makes life interesting. Overcoming those challenges is what will make your life meaningful. You've overcome one big challenge, and our celebration today gives it meaning. So now, my simple and honest words of wisdom. You may have heard them before. Your future, seniors, your future is just starting to be created. What you make of your future as a graduate is up to you. I challenge you to make the most of it. I'll say it again. The challenges you will face are what makes life interesting, and overcoming those challenges is what will make your life meaningful. Keep getting an education. No matter what you choose to do, no matter how fast or slow you choose to do it, keep getting an education. Education is the great equalizer. Pay for it now. It will pay you back in the future. I know what you learned in Lakeview. You are prepared for a world with endless opportunity. Good luck. Have a great future. And always remember your Husky pride. Now I'd like to pass the microphone off to Mr. Dombrowski, our board president, for a few words.
Thank you, Mr. Paulson. On behalf of the Lakeview Public Schools Board of Education, I'd like to welcome all to today's Class of 2020 graduation, Lakeview's 89th graduation. Traditions are an important part of any organization, and in schools, the tradition of graduation is a particularly moving and uplifting event. This is a time when we as school board members, administrators, teachers, support staff, parents, and families applaud the academic, athletic, artistic, musical, and social accomplishments of each of you. Graduation also gives us the opportunity to celebrate the many fine accomplishments of individual members of the class of 2020. While these honors are given to individuals, All honors reflect on the quality of the entire class. I know that you celebrate with me as we recognize the following 8 individuals for their outstanding achievements, noting that the first 7 awards are considered of equal ranking, and the 8th award, the Robert H. Schauble Award, is considered the top award. First we have is the Balfour Award. This is the oldest of our awards. The recipients' names date back to the 1962 on 3 of the 4 Balfour plaques we have. The missing plaque predates the 1960s. A plaque to be presented at commencement to the senior that was voted on by the faculty based upon service and scholarship. The 2020 recipient of the Balfour Award is Leah Sargent. Next we have is the Richard Black Award. First awarded in 1970, this plaque is presented to the senior that was voted on by the faculty based upon leadership, athleticism, and scholarship. The 2020 recipient of the Richard Black Award is Madison Dembski. Next we have is the Honor Award. Initially awarded in 1962, a plaque to be presented at commencement to the senior who was voted on by the faculty based upon leadership, service, and scholarship. The 2020 recipient of the Honor Award is Carolyn Oster. Next we have is the Co-Ed Service Award. This award was first presented in 1962. A plaque to be presented at commencement to the senior that was voted on by the faculty based upon character, service, and scholarship. The 2020 recipient of the Co-Ed Service Award is Nicholas Rezepa. Next we have is the Christine Neiman Award. This award originated in 1963, named in honor of a former math and Latin teacher who was a member of one of St. Clair Shores' original families. Neiman Street was named after this family. A plaque to be presented at commencement to the senior that was voted on by the faculty based upon character and scholarship. The 2020 recipient of the Christine Neiman Award is Haley Single. Next we have is the William Srigley Civic School Award. Mr. Srigley was a member of the Lakeview Board of Education. In 2008, his family made an endowment to the Alumni Association providing professional development money to a teacher and the Srigley Award to a senior who has demonstrated leadership and scholarship. The 2020 recipient of the William Srigley Civic School Award is McKenna Connell. Next we have is the Ian Smith Award. Mr. Ian Smith Sr. is a former Lakeview Board of Education president. A plaque to be presented at commencement to the senior that was voted on by the faculty based upon leadership, service, and scholarship. The 2020 recipient of the Ian Smith Award is Mary Holton. This brings us to the Robert H. Schauble Award. Mr. Robert H. Schauble served honorably as Lakeview High School principal from 1951 to 1978. He also served the district as superintendent of schools. This plaque is awarded to the most outstanding senior as voted on by the faculty. Criteria for this award: character, leadership, service, and scholarship. This honor has been awarded to our top senior since 1967. The 2020 recipient of the Robert H. Schauble Award is Corey Cranford. While we navigate through these unprecedented times in 2020, we, as a Board of Education, honorably congratulate the class of 2020. I know there were many things that you have missed out on collectively, but in the grand scheme of things, as we are in education, we all have learned a lot on how to deal with the challenges of life as it stands today. So as we move forward, congratulations to all the students of the class of 2020 and all the best to you moving forward. I now present, or I'd like to call back Mr. Kepler to the podium. Thank you.
It is now my pleasure to introduce Lakeview High School's class of 2020 salutatorian, Caroline Oster. Caroline is the youngest daughter of Valerie and Joe. At Lakeview, Caroline was part of the National Honor Society for 3 years. Caroline is a four-year varsity golf and tennis player. In addition, Caroline has been in 7 Lakeview community musicals. Caroline will be attending the University of Michigan Ann Arbor in the fall and will major in cognitive science. Ladies and gentlemen, Caroline Oster.
Good afternoon, and welcome to Lakeview's first ever virtual graduation. I know this isn't the send-off we imagined, but I'm so proud of each and every one of my fellow graduates. I've truly missed seeing all of you every day in the halls, and yes, that includes my uncle, Mr. Oster. After everything the world has thrown at us, we're finally here to celebrate not just the end of this chapter of our lives, but the start of a whole new horizon. Graduation is already a transition into adult life, but it just so happens to coincide with our transition into a post-pandemic life. For many of us, post-COVID and post-quarantine plans might not look all that different. Maybe you'll spend some quality time with your grandparents who you've been distanced from. I know how hard it's been without seeing the people you care most about. Trust me, I burst into tears the second I reunited with my best friend, who I just so happened to be sharing the stage with, as she is our valedictorian. Maybe you'll go back to school or start searching for a new job. Maybe you'll join the thousands of people across the country and beyond who are raising their voices against racism and inequality while we've been tucked away in our bedrooms. As so many people across the nation are fighting for their voices to be heard, what will your impact be? How will you find your voice after high school? I don't know everything. Shocking, I know. But I do want to share one tip on how to succeed in whatever path you follow after crossing the stage. We are always told to face our fears, and I think the hardest one to face is the fear of failure, because it's deceptively motivating. All my fellow procrastinators know exactly what I'm talking about. That sudden burst of panicked energy and adrenaline the night before the papers due. What you might not notice, however, is that same fear is keeping you from trying new things that might spark your passion. For example, I think karaoke is the perfect way to feel firsthand what letting go of fear and its inhibitions leads to. It doesn't matter how good of a singer you are. What matters is the enthusiasm, the spark in your eye, the smile as you attempt to hit the high note. You've got to own it. If you believe in your performance, people will rally around you, even if you happen to fail at the attempt. Whatever you want to pursue, let go of your expectations of perfection. I know it's not easy and can even be terrifying. I've struggled to do this for most of my life, and I can say that my proudest moments came when I allowed myself to perform freely, without fears or reservations. The last time I was on this stage was the closing night of The King and I, which was an emotional moment that I will forever treasure. I'm not saying that everyone needs to break out into song and dance without a care in the world in order to face your fears. But find something that you want to pursue so much that you stop caring about others' opinions. If you trip on the first step, so what? Own it. Get up and keep climbing. As long as you show that you're dedicated, your friends will help you get back on your feet. I want to leave you all with a quote from The Little Prince that has guided me since I read it in Mrs. Bowen's French 3 class. on ne voit bien qu'avec le cœur. L'essentiel est invisible pour les yeux. In English, it is only with the heart that one can see rightly. What is essential is invisible to the eye. As we leave Lakeview, we will undoubtedly be pushed out of our comfort zones at times. There's a long road of tough decisions and turmoil ahead of us, but also so many possibilities for us to flourish and find out who we are, what we're meant to be. Hold your passions for what you do and your most meaningful relationships close. These are the essential things that are invisible to the eye. We may be going different ways, but we've already shown that distance can't stop us from staying connected to each other. Thank you to all of the teachers and staff who worked so hard under the most challenging circumstances to make this moment possible for us. Congratulations again to the class of 2020, because despite COVID, remote learning, and social distancing, we made it. Thank you.
Thank you, Caroline. It is now my pleasure to introduce the valedictorian and president of the class of 2020, Madison Demski. Madison is the youngest daughter of Callie and Ron. At Lakeview, Madison was part of the National Honor Society for 3 years, Huskies with Heart for 4 years, with 2 years as vice president, and Mu Alpha Theta for 4 years. Madison is a four-year varsity soccer player as well. Madison will be attending University of Michigan Ann Arbor in the fall and will major in biology. Ladies and gentlemen, Madison Demski.
Good afternoon, parents, administrators, and most importantly, the graduating class of 2020. I can safely say we made it. After enduring 3 months of Google Hangouts and scrambling Thursday nights to get all of our required assignments for the week done, countless hours lost scrolling through TikTok, and way too many attempts at making Dalgona whipped coffee, we have finally wrapped up our chapter at Lakeview. As hard as it is to imagine, and as much as this is not what anyone was expecting to come of our final year in high school, we did it. 4 years ago, we walked through the doors of our school, or if you were running late, then you ran through the doors. We were shorter, younger, and much more motivated, you know, before senioritis kicked in. We came in wide-eyed, eager, and maybe even a little nervous to navigate what we thought were the huge hallways. Freshman year was the start of what would be a lasting legacy here at Lakeview. That year, we beat the seniors out in the boat regatta, and we didn't place last in our homecoming float. Sophomore year was a year. I don't know about you, but it was mostly a blur, kind of like the last few weeks of quarantine. Junior year was what I would describe as Miss Nicki Minaj's second verse in Roman Holiday. We were all scrambling to study for the SAT while maintaining our grades to graduate on time and impress college admission boards. After all of that, we finally made it to our senior year. This year alone, our Powderpuff team beat Lakeshore, again, might I add. Our varsity football team made it to the district championships, and our girls' varsity basketball team won districts. All was well. We attended our last homecoming, cranked out college application after college application, and began seeking out stable jobs. New Year's came and went, and there were so many terrible puns about having 2020 vision and the future being clear. Unbeknownst to us, March 13th would be our last day of high school. COVID-19 was a wrench in all of our lives. It has affected us, our loved ones, our friends, and citizens around the world. From what we have seen on the news, no one could have been prepared for the severity and seriousness of this pandemic. Losing out on the last few months of our senior year was just an unpredictable consequence. However, I'm not here to remind you of the terror and fear we all felt at the possibility of running out of toilet paper. That's because we should not dwell. We should not dwell on what we have lost, but rather we should focus on what we have gained and what we should carry forth with us into life after Lakeview. These next pieces of advice are just a few things I have learned through my own trials and tribulations over the past 4 years and the time I spent locked in my house. Be kind. Mr. Rogers' children's show creator and host once said, "There are three ways to ultimate success. The first way is to be kind, the second way is to be kind, the third way is to be kind." Kindness reaches far beyond any border. It sees no race, no religion, no ethnicity, no gender identity, and no sexual orientation. Kindness is free and should be exploited to its full extent. Be conscious of your reactions. We cannot control the virus, and we cannot control the fact that we spent the last few months of our senior year in quarantine. What we can control, however, is our reaction to these events and the others that will occur in the future. It is said that 10% of life is what happens to you, and 90% is how you react to it. Roll with the tide. Life will try to knock you down. Take the hits and stand back up in stride. Don't get discouraged. Allow yourself to adapt to changes because you grow from them. We are proof of that. Speak up for what you believe in. Pour conviction into your words and speak with sincerity. Speak up because the day you don't speak up for the things that matter to you is the day your freedom truly ends. Exude love. Love your peers and love your parents. Love what you do and do what you love. Love simply waking up every day and being able to contribute to the world around you. And most importantly, love yourself. We should all be proud of this accomplishment. After 13 years of hard work, tears, one too many all-nighters, and time spent watching ad after ad on Slater just to figure out our math homework, we have graduated. Whether you are going to college, to trade school, to the military, or to the workforce, remember to be kind, be present, be strong, speak up, and give love. Our class will go down in history. In a few years, Mr. Harrit-Sarris and Mr. Goyke will make their students write a DBQ on the great pandemic of 2020. Ms. Merrill and Ms. Boone will teach their biology students about COVID and their virus unit. And Ms. Kalinowski will make her stats student run hypothesis tests on the proportion of COVID cases in our nation. I would argue that we are connected now more than we were before, because we share this common experience. Just as older generations have gone on about having to trek 30 miles uphill through snow to get to school, we have our own story to tell. You know, we were the class with the longest senior skip day. I am beyond thankful to have had the honor of addressing all of you today on behalf of our graduating class. Thank you, teachers, for the time and effort you've put into every day at school and for making the transition to remote learning simple and smooth. Thank you, parents, guardians, and supporters, for giving us unwavering love. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for putting up with me through this chaotic transition into adulthood. And thank you to all of my friends for inspiring me to be unapologetically myself and for sticking with me through thick and thin. Lakeview's class of 2020 has a long road of life ahead of them, but I believe we are more than prepared. Congratulations, graduates, and good luck on all your future endeavors. Oh, and for one last time, go Huskies. Thank you.
Class of 2020 graduates. Not in a million years would I have imagined that we would find ourselves in this situation. What you have endured as a class, no one in the entire history of graduating classes within the United States can say they experienced. Think about that for a moment. The COVID-19 virus has turned our worlds upside down, and through it all, you have illustrated the qualities of not only what it means to be a Husky, but what it means to be a quality human being. Certainly, this class, more so than any graduating class before it, will always be remembered. I would argue, however, that you will not be remembered for what happened to you. You can't control that. I believe you will be remembered for how you have responded. You have taken a negative and turned it into a positive. In life, as you just found out through this virus, there are things you cannot control. There may be events as you grow older that you simply do not have an answer for. And that's okay. How you respond to a situation says more about you as a person. Others will look to you as a leader in tough times, and they will look for direction and leadership, for which I have no doubt you will provide. How you take a negative and find a positive in it will define who you are. People will gravitate to you, and you will lead them. As you can see, very few situations define who a person is. It's how that person reacts to that situation is what truly defines who they are, the character they possess. The character you all possess as you graduate with your peers has certainly defined this class. What will this class be remembered for? Easy. They will be remembered for their hard work, resilience, and commitment, all qualities that define what it means not only to be a Husky, but a good person. The class of 2020 will be remembered for not what happened to them, but how they rose to the challenge and responded. So, what happens now? Well, I believe the qualities that you have exhibited as a class will carry you through your lives after graduation. The qualities of resiliency, work ethic, and commitment have gotten you to this point, and because of those qualities, you have made it to this important day, 2020 commencements. As much as this might feel like the end, it is only the beginning. You all have many promising opportunities to look forward to in your lives. So, what are you going to do? I know what you won't do. I know you won't back down. I know you won't give up. I know you won't stop until you have achieved what you have set out to do. That is the great lesson in all of this. You have never been more prepared to face the challenges of this world, especially after this pandemic. You are mentally prepared to face and conquer all challenges that come your way. You see, talent is abundant. Talent is all around us. However, what good is talent without the qualities of the class of 2020? Resilience, work ethic, and commitment. I'll tell you a secret. Talent is easy to overcome when the qualities of resilience, work ethic, and commitment are in place. You possess those qualities and possess talent. That combination cannot be overcome. That combination will take you places you never imagined. Will it be easy? Nope. Will you encounter obstacles and problems? Probably. But if you have those qualities in place and you have talent, the world is yours. You can overcome anything, and as your principal, I could not be more proud. Your Husky spirit will always remain at Lakeview long after this day. The relationships you forged, the experiences you shared, and the dreams you dreamt as a class will forever remain. So go out, dream your dreams, and do not quit until you have accomplished what you have set out to do. Congratulations to the class of 2020.